Fight Club, Seven, Gone Girl, Zodiac. You can get excited for a movie just based off knowing who's directing it and not really need to know anything about the story or characters, really.
Right, yeah. You I just trust their storytelling ability. Yeah,
exactly. Jinx.
Oh, it's so eerie.
Simple.
Wow. Oh, wow. Man, the graphics, the close-up shots. The freaking
Netflix,
just the
November 10th.
The control of the camera. Like, God, that looks amazing.
Welcome. The Backseat Directing,
where we talk about movies, TV shows, comics, and more.
We're your hosts,
Andrew
and Aaron,
and we put out new episodes every Monday and Thursday.
And today we're reacting to the new David Fincher movie, The Killer.
3, 2, 1, action.
We're reacting to the trailer.
Yeah,
I didn't say the trailer.
To be clear,
so like the movie, we haven't seen the movie because no one invites us to watch an early screening of a movie yet.
Oh
so.
No, Fincher invited us. The director, he invited us, and I had to turn him down because we had other obligations.
Oh well, that kind of feels like a big deal. Like why? What else could we have been doing?
Yeah, no, I'm pretty sure that we had something like very important going on that weekend. We had like several other movie premieres we were interviewing.
I mean, we are pretty booked, you know.
We're pretty booked out.
Maybe it was too last minute. still can't believe you didn't like let me know at least.
He'll remember next time to try and give us a little bit more heads up.
Okay, yeah. So there's that. All right. You want to just, have you seen this trailer yet?
I have not seen the trailer.
Me neither. I'm excited for it. This was one of the movies that we pointed out at the beginning of the year that we're looking forward to. It's actually premiering in theaters a little bit, but then going to Netflix a few weeks later.
I'd love to see this in theaters. I hope place it somewhere reasonably near us showing it, because I love David Fincher. So I'm excited for this movie. It's based off a comic book. It's dark, which is like the Fincher theme basically. And I like serial killer stuff. I like David Fincher. So I think this movie is going to have like a really cool vibe. I like the David Fincher, like rainy day, dark, like ominous vibe. So I'm pumped for this.
Yeah, Andrew's like a little white girl when it comes to serial killers.
My inner little white girl.
You ready?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. The Killer.
Look at the size of that
sniper rifle.
Dude, those close-ups are sick.
Trust no one.
If you're not vibing to this music right now, you're lying.
Forbid empathy. Stick to the plan. Anticipate. Don't improvise.
Oh, it's so eerie.
Advantage.
I love the speed.
Stick to your plan. Only the battle you're paid to fight. Ask yourself, what's in it for me? Stick to the plan. Empathy, weakness, vulnerability. This is what it takes if you want to succeed. Simple.
Wow. Oh, wow. Man, the graphics, the close-up shots.
Dude.
Freaking
Netflix,
just the
November
speed,
10th.
The control of the camera, like, God, that looks amazing. My God, that movie looks so good. I'm so excited.
That was a good trailer.
That was a really good trailer. Like, I love the narration. To be clear, I called him a serial killer, but I think it's more of a
assassin
hitman.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, is also a serial killer, just with a different flavor.
Right.
Like a serial killer for hire. But dang, that was a good trailer. The team up of Michael Fassbender and David Fincher is like the marriage I didn't know I needed. Like, God, man, I love both of them. Michael Fassbender is such a talented actor.
Yes.
David Fincher, such a talented director. One of the best to ever do it. My personal top three favorite directors of all time. This looks like it has some flair. Like the way the letters show up on the screen.
It looked intense, right?
It looks very intense. But like the graphics and lettering on the screen that said from the director of Seven and all those other films. And then it also had the one with the name at the end where Killer, where the eye falls over to the side, like a shell casing falling over. It feels, that feels like comic-esque, like the print. So it's cool, the homage back to the comic that this is based on. And
have you read the comic?
I have not, but I'd like to actually read it before it comes out.
Yeah, we should
get it.
We should do that.
And maybe like even review the comic or review it along with the movie.
The summary on IMDb says, after a fearful near miss, an assassin battles his employers and himself on an internal or international manhunt he insists isn't personal.
Interesting. There's going to be some like inner turmoil and like depth of themes in this movie, because that's just what I expect from Fincher. Like, his movies have this very, very particular feeling when you watch them. Like, I'm gripped to the edge of my seat. I'm always incredibly impressed by like the immense control he displays as a filmmaker. And I feel like he drives my emotions in a way that few other filmmakers really can.
He's the director that does like 80 shots per scene sometimes, right? Where he's just like keeps going.
Yeah, he's very famously known for like doing lots and lots of takes, because he's a very precise, very controlled filmmaker. I've seen people compare it to like a God complex, where like God needs to be in total control. And like when Fincher's making a film, he needs to be like in control of what's in camera, what you see, what you don't see. He's very masterful in that sense. Like, he's very limited in his use of special effects. He'll use like maybe a little bit of green screen to substitute a shot, like maybe through a window where you'll hardly notice it. But the way he uses it is in such a knowledgeable manner. Like, he uses it in a way of knowing when's the best time and the best way to use it so that it doesn't take you out of the movie.
Well, he creates a lot of like real world movies.
Yeah.
You know,
so if you don't,
very grounded.
If you're not familiar with David Fincher's work, he's notably made the movies Fight Club, Seven, Gone Girl, That's Zodiac. Right.
Can you start naming better movies, please?
Social Network. I can. Dude, he's made some really incredible movies, and like his movies, Social Network, Fight Club, and Seven are all like contenders for my top 10, being my top 10 favorite movies of all time. So all from one director is really amazing.
Yeah, I love all those movies too. I'm excited for this. Does it make you nervous at all that it's a kind of a direct-to-streaming movie?
It does.
Yeah.
But the thing is though, direct-to-streaming movies, they can be very good, but they also
normally aren't.
They also, I think maybe it's a touch of the studio involvement with the streaming, and then a touch of like, the budget just seems to work out so differently in these streaming movies. Like, maybe the lots or productions they're working on just aren't as up to snuff as like theater production sets. But like, I always go back to The Gray Man, how like that movie had such a big budget, being amazing directors, the Russo
top siblings, actors,
top actors like Chris Evans and Ryan Gosling. And then it looks bad, and like the story's nothing enthralling, but then you have like The Irishman on Netflix, which like got a bunch of Oscar nominations. So maybe like this, I mean, Martin Scorsese has a movie coming out again this year with streaming. He has,
in October, I believe. Yeah,
Killers of the Flower Moon. He has coming out with Apple Plus or Apple TV or whatever it's called. And he also had The Irishman previously on Netflix a couple years ago. So now we have David Fincher doing a movie with Netflix. Like, it seems to be the way the tide's turning, and it seems to be that the filmmakers, the titans of like directing, are turning that way too. So I have to believe that they wouldn't accept making like a subpar movie. And I know there are complaints too with some of the de-aging in The Irishman, but I feel like at the end of the day, it's kind of a small complaint overall in terms of like the quality of a movie. So
I mean, you just complained about The Gray Man not looking good because of its special effects.
Yeah, but in The Gray Man, it was like, I feel like the de-aging, what I mean is that the de-aging is smaller in sense of maybe not as noticeable as like the shots in the crashing plane sequence in The Gray Man, where I'm like, oh my God, this looks like absolute shit. Like, I can't believe this movie cost like over $100 million to make. Why did they film this way?
$200 million.
That's crazy. But the directors of that movie are so good.
Yeah,
like,
right.
Actually, like when I'm like, oh, an action movie, like spy thriller with the Russo siblings. They did Endgame. They did Captain America Civil War, which is a spy movie. Like,
yep. And just Infinity War. Yeah.
So yeah.
Winter Soldier.
It makes you a little bit nervous, but then the trailer comes along like that and introduces new confidence. Like, I was like enthralled to the trailer. Like, I was like, wait, I'm supposed to be reacting to this, but I was watching it like,
it was a really good first trailer, right? Like, it really didn't give anything away at all.
Cause it moved too fast.
Yeah.
It showed a lot, but not a lot.
Yeah. Like, you can't really tell what that movie was about from the trailer.
Which I learned more from your description.
Yeah,
you
right.
Of what it was about than the
trailer. No, exactly.
And but I'm totally fine with that.
I think that's what a first trailer is supposed to do. And then the second trailer kind of gives you more of the detail of the story. Maybe borderline too much, depending on the studio, Marvel, DC.
Yeah.
And then the third trailer is kind of like they really reveal things to as a last minute, like, hey, come last resort kind of thing. So normally I'll tend to just try to watch just the first trailer of things that I know I'm going to go see. And I'm going to see this. It comes to theaters for a limited release October 27th and then is streaming literally a week or two later on November 10th.
And Halloween, what a good time for a release for like a horror movie or a thriller, you know, a killer movie. I think that is going to generate more buzz for the movie, even if it's like a limited theater
release. Yeah, it fits the tone. I'm not sure what limited theater release means. You know, is that just not that many theaters or is it not that long of a time in the theaters?
It's definitely not going to be a wide release in theaters in terms of like
every theater has this movie.
Yeah, it's gonna be I don't know, because limited, like you're saying, like limited can vary a lot. Like it could be like maybe only the big theaters around you are getting it, or it could be like maybe you gotta drive to like a 3-hour drive to like Miami to find
your my concern as a filmmaker, if we were making something for streaming, is that like it comes out, it's talked about for a week, and then it just disappears. When it goes into theaters, whether it's doing good or bad, it's talked about for 3-4 weeks. You know, like Barbie's still going, you know, like you hear about it being talked about more often. But now it's like, hey, it's on Netflix. Everyone can watch it.
Yeah. Okay. We'll get the chance when it comes out to, we'll definitely review it and we'll get the chance to compare how his streaming movie goes versus like his big theater release movies.
Yeah. Anything else you want to say about this movie?
I'm super excited for it. I mean, the trailer, like I said during it, I was fascinated with the close-up shots, the looks at his eyes, his hands, like the music. Oh, dude, we didn't get to talk about the music yet, but that music
looks good. Oh, in the trailer, yeah.
It opens really strong with the music, and it's like had me bop into my seat. Like everything about that trailer was like speed, speed, speed. So I hope this movie moves at a good clip. It has good action. Michael Fassbender looked jacked when they showed him in the shower. But I'm super excited, and I hope other people are excited too. Let us know in the comments what you think about this movie. Do you like David Fincher? Are you sitting here saying, who's David Fincher? But are you excited for this movie because of David Fincher like we are? Like, when it's cool about knowing directors is that you can get excited for a movie just based off knowing who's directing it and not really need to know anything about the story or characters, really.
Right, yeah.
I trust
their storytelling ability. Yeah,
exactly. Jinx. I have total faith
dynamic duo
in David Fincher to make a good movie. And I recently rewatched Gone Girl, and I didn't like it as much as my initial viewing.
Really? I just rewatched it a few weeks ago, too, and I loved it.
I still...
I did the first time.
I still like it. I still like it. It's a good movie, but... I didn't like it as much as the first time I watched it, but with that said...
I think
like,
you're just watching too many movies at once.
Even David Fincher's worst movie is still a great movie. That's my perspective on him as a filmmaker.
Do you think Gone Girl is his worst movie?
No, I don't think it's his worst movie.
Okay, good.
I do still have to rewatch Zodiac and everything, so...
All right. We'll look into the comic.
Yeah, right? we'll look into the comic and we
can talk cool about it more. It's cool that's a comic book movie that's not about superheroes.
Yeah.
At least it doesn't look like
because there's so many of those. Not a lot of people know it, but there's so many comic book movies that aren't about superheroes, you know?
Yeah. There's so many comics that aren't just about superheroes.
Yeah.
You know, like it seems like comics and superheroes are like one in the same.
But it's really not.
Yeah. Comics tell stories all over the map, all over every genre.
I'm excited to see how David Fincher films action in this because he has an incredible foot chase scene in Seven, but... Usually, I don't feel like he's filming fight scenes. So, and I think this movie is gonna.
It's a good question. Yeah,
potentially have some of that.
Yeah,
I'm definitely looking forward to it. I'm optimistic, and I'm excited to see what they put out. You're excited for this movie too, it seems.
Absolutely. Yeah, let's do it.
Let's
give it to me now.
Let's do it. Let's review it.
All right, guys. Thanks everyone for watching. We're wearing our new blacked out T-shirts. Backseat Directing. You can check those out on Etsy. Backseat Directing. We have it in the comments of our YouTube channel, this episode and the last few episodes as well. It's in the link in the bio for all of our social medias. We post new full episodes every Monday and Thursday, so be sure to hit that notification bell so you are aware of when we're posting. Thanks everyone for watching, and that's a wrap.